Oh, very good morning to all my lovely children. Welcome to our virtual classes. This is Monica ma'am, your English teacher. I hope all of you are keeping fine. Yesterday we learnt about recipe writing. I hope all of you have done the activity and must have enjoyed writing the recipe of vegetable sandwich. Now let us continue with today's lesson. Dear children, imagine a feast with tasty food items including juicy strawberries, refreshing watermelon, creamy cheesecake, chocolate buttercream cupcakes, and of course your favorite candies, that is the jelly beans. Don't this sound so delicious and heavenly? Now, what do all these food items have in common besides being mouth-watering? Can you tell me? I'm repeating the names: strawberry, watermelon, cupcakes, cheesecake, and jelly beans. So let me tell you, they all have one thing in common, that is the names of these food items are compound words. So dear children, our topic for today is compound words. Let's have a look at its definition. Compound words are formed when two or more words are joined together to create a new word that has entirely new meaning. With this, we understand that a compound noun is formed when two words are combined to make a new word. This means that the meaning of a new word must be significantly different than either of its parts individually. Let us see some examples now. Rain plus coat becomes raincoat. Pan plus cake becomes pancake. Ear plus ring becomes earring. And snow plus men is snowman. Here you can see that there are two different nouns with different meanings. But when they are joined together, they form a new word with an entire new meaning. These type of words are called the compound words, because compound means made up or consisting of several parts or elements. And here you can see that they are comprising of two different kinds of words, two different nouns, and making a new word with entirely different meaning. Now let us move to the next topic, that is kinds of compound words. Not all compound words are put together the same way. They are categorized in three different ways. The three categories are the closed compound words, open compound words, and hyphenated compound words. Let us understand these with some examples. Now have a look at these words. The first word is fireworks, grandmother, crosswalk, sunflower, basketball, and moonlight. These are the examples of closed compound words. Now, closed compound words are formed when two unique words are joined together. They don't have a space between them, and they are the type that generally comes to mind when we think of compound words. So these are the most common compound words that we generally frame whenever we are asked to make compound words. There is no space between the words over here. Like we have joined fire with works, but there is no space in between. Sun is a different word, a different noun. Flower is a different noun, a different word. But when fused together, it becomes sunflower. एंड देर इज नो गैप इन बिटवीन. सच काइंड ऑफ वर्ड्स आर कॉल्ड द क्लोज्ड कंपाउंड वर्ड्स. लेट्स लुक एट सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ वन वर्ड कंपाउंड नाउन्स. आर्म चेयर, बेड स्प्रेड, ब्लैक बोर्ड. नाउ लुक एट दीज वर्ड्स. आइसक्रीम, ग्रैंड ज्यूरी, फुल मून, पोस्ट ऑफिस, रियल एस्टेट, मिडिल क्लास. नाउ हियर यू कैन सी दैट दीज कंपाउंड वर्ड्स हैव अ स्पेस बिटवीन देम. नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कंपाउंड वर्ड्स आर दीज. सच वर्ड्स आर कॉल्ड ओपन कंपाउंड वर्ड्स. ओपन कंपाउंड वर्ड्स हैव अ स्पेस बिटवीन देम, बट वेन दे आर रेड टूगेदर अ न्यू मीनिंग इज फॉर्म्ड. एज इन इफ वी से फुल मून, बोथ हैव डिफरेंट मीनिंग्स, बट वेन वी स्पीक देम टूगेदर एंड दैट टू इट गिव्स अ सिग्निफिकेंट न्यू मीनिंग टू द वर्ड. Examples of separate words, that is the open compound words. Ice cream, hairbrush, coat stand, magazine rack, alarm clock, dishwasher, sewing machine. Now let us read these words. One half, mother-in-law, 86, one third, merry-go-round, well-being. In these words, you can see that I have placed a small dash in between. This dash is termed as hyphen in English. So, these are the hyphenated compound words. These are formed when they are connected with a hyphen, that is a symbol like this. Here you can see in the examples. Let's see some examples of hyphenated words. 16-year-old, editor-in-chief, great-grandson. Now here you can see one example of each kind of compound noun in one frame. That is the closed form, hyphenated form and open form. Softball is a closed form where there is no space between the two words. Hyphenated, here we have a small hyphen between the two words. And open form where there is no hyphen, they are not close to each other. Instead, there is a space between both the words. So here we end with the topic compound words, and we can conclude by saying that when two or more words are joined together, they form a new word, and that is called a compound word. And compound word has three parts, that is they can be written as one word, separate word and hyphenated words. I hope all of you have understood the compound nouns well. Now your today's homework is based on the same topic. You have to do the worksheet in your English notebook. We'll meet you tomorrow. Till then, thank you. Take care. Bye-bye and stay in shape.